Welcome back to my second video. I'm Grapple544, and today we're going to be doing a little story time about public speaking. So, let's get to it. I'm going to get to this little parkour place. Start parkour. Okay, boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Have fun, okay. So, the story starts around when I'm still in kindergarten. I'm about to go to, like, my first, like, preschool, first grade, and I was chosen to, like, orient a little speech, right? I had to do a little speech, and in our school, we had, like, class A, class B. Class A was basically more musically talented class or something. I was in class A. That basically meant you had choir. Class B didn't have choir, so that's basically all that was to it. Where do you get out? Oh, here. So, I had to do, like, a little speech. In class B, they had a short speech, like, maybe 3 sentences, right? No, it wasn't a speech. It was a poem. Yeah, a poem. But my poem was, like, really pretty long. Pretty long. It had, like, 10 sentences. Even more than 10, I think. And you know what didn't help? That I had to do it in, like, a dialect, a different type of way of speech, like an accent or something. And it wasn't an accent I'm good at, right? I have accents I'm good at and do in, like, actual, like, public speaking all the time, right? And I'm good at them, right? But this one, nah, I was just starting out anyway. So, I'm just, like, going through the thing. I'm stuttering a little, right? Just saying everything, trying to get everything right. But then I realize I'm forgetting some of the words. I don't know. What do I say? And the only thing that comes to my mind is to say, I don't remember. So I just yell that out. Like, I don't remember. Then my mom comes up to me. And she's like, okay, these are the words. And I'm like, okay. I start like saying the thing again. And I'm like, I still don't remember. And then I just go off the stage. Everyone's like laughing and just laughing. I'm like, oh my goodness. But turns out they loved it, and Facebook loved it too. So I was, like, all over Facebook for, like, the next week or so. And people were, like, calling my mom and saying, like, oh my goodness, that was so cute. How he said, like, I don't remember, so cute. I think they called my mom, because I got, like, my mom told me, like, oh, people are saying, oh, that's cool, like, and all that type stuff. And then I think it was the first or second grade, we had, like, a little competition where you can get to tell, like, a little poem, and you can move on to the second level or something. The first level was class type, yeah? People show up there, little class level, the whole class competes, right? People just showed up with their little poem thingies, right? Some were short, some were kind of bad. Some were kind of bad, right? Some were pretty good, actually, right? I had a kind of long one, like, I'd say 7 sentences, something like that. And I'm just, like, telling the thing, and a bunch of a little group with me also in it got to the second, like, level. That was, like, the school level where all the other grades competed too. I got through that one too. It's a little smaller group from my class. And then came, like, after that came the city level. And, yeah, some few, like 2 people came through. I was one of them, right? And then it was the regional. Keep in mind, all this time I'm just saying the same thing, you know? saying the same thing. In the regional, we get there, like, tell our little stories. I didn't get over the regional one for the first year, but I think one of my friends, basically got there because, like, there was one of this older dude, right, who was competing in the contest for, like, 5 years or something. And he really liked her, like, a little poem, and that's why he gave his ticket to, like, the state competition to her, right? And she, like, gets to the state competition, but enough about that. I don't know what was her result, but, yeah, she got to the state competition because of that little bit, because of that dude who gave her a little ticket to... Well, the state competition. But the next year, around the same story again, I tell like a little speech to get from the class or a little group that was smaller than the last time. Then to like school, city, region. And then, like, the state one, and this time I actually got to the state one, and I get the highest rank you can get. It was, like, epic storyteller or something, right? And I get it. And then I found out the thing that if you get 3 epic storytellers in a row, you can get, like, the 4th year, you can compete for the king of for the title of king of storyteller storytelling, right? Not like getting hyped, just like trying to win the epic storyteller. And I get like to actually to the next year I also get it, but then I start feeling like I don't like this anymore. But the next year, technically like last year, yeah, 2021, I'm like sitting in my class and our teacher again announces that, oh, the storytelling competition is happening again. And she's like, oh Grappo, I already know you're competing, and it's all good. My name ain't Grappo. I'm just not saying my real name for privacy reasons. Yeah, she's like, okay, I already know you're competing, I already sent you the little email of the rules again, and I'm like, well, okay, I don't have a choice anymore, do I? And that year, yeah, I still got, like, the final, like, state thingy, but keep in mind, this year, it was, like, basically on like because of COVID, it was filmed on cameras. Actually, the second year was too, like 2020 and 2021 were like on camera. You had to film yourself telling the whole story, dressed up. That was really annoying because then you had a chance to like do multiple times. That led to doing the thing multiple times, and that gets really annoying after the fifth try, okay? Cause you're just like super tired and you just wanna go play some video games or something. Your mom like, no, we can do better this time, we have a second option. This time we have the chance to do it again, so we can do better. And yeah, then you just end up filming yourself like 13 times, and then you're just tired out and wasted the whole day because you didn't get a good clip, and then you have to do it the second day all over. And this usually would take up all my weekend time, and that's why I started to dislike the thing, because of the filming type thing. But this year, 2022, I'm competing for the King of Storytelling little title. And I'm pretty happy about it, right? Because I'll be the King of Storytelling. Probably. I hope I'll be the King of Storytelling. If I'm not, well, this whole thing was a waste of time. Yeah, it really actually got me in, like, where I am today in speaking. Because if I wouldn't have, like, done all of these little contests, I would probably not speak, like, this comfortably right now. I'd just be going, like, hey guys, well, not that bad. That just sounds like I have a voice changer on or something. But I just wouldn't be as comfortable in public speaking or like speaking on YouTube if I wouldn't have done like the public speaking things. So I'm thankful I did them. And yeah, I'm just. Now I know how to speak good. Now, yeah. And I combine that with, like, my knowings of the English language. And now I speak pretty good in English, too. So, that's a nice thing. Now I got a good voice for YouTube. But I think that's gonna wrap it up for this video. Stay tuned for the next one, and goodbye.